गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल हैव आवर अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ डिजाइन ऑफ मशीन एलिमेंट एंड टुडेज टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज डिजाइन ऑफ स्क्रू जैक। सो दिस इज द बेसिक डायमेंशन और बेसिक 2D डायग्राम आई कैन से और वन साइड व्यू ऑफ अ स्क्रू जैक वेयर ऑल द डायमेंशनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द स्क्रू जैक इज बींग मेंशनड हियर। सो if you start from the overall W, that is the load is being attached at the upper end W, this is the whole part is the cup pin handle, this is the nut section and this is the screw one. So it is being totally assigned into a complete figure of screw jack. It starts with the nomenclature of this. So at first DC is given. DC is the core diameter of screw. This is the DC and this is the core diameter of screw. Now D naught is the nominal diameter of screw. This is the D naught and this is the nominal diameter of the screw. So now coming to DM. DM is the mean diameter of screw and DM will be the mean diameter of that screw. So now next the D1. D1 will be the inner diameter of nut. Capital D1 will be the inner diameter of nut. D2 will be the outer diameter of nut. All these nomenclatures are being mentioned in the given figure. You can go through one by one. Now D3 will be the diameter of head and it can be calculated by the formula 1.75 into D naught, and A naught will be the nominal diameter. The D4 will be the diameter of pin in collar and that can be easily determined by the formula 0.25 into D3. D5 will be the diameter of body at top and it can be calculated by 1.5 into D2. D6 will be the inside diameter at the bottom, that can be calculated by 2.25 into D2. D7 will be the outside diameter at bottom, it will be calculated by 1.75 into D6. T will be the width or thickness of screw thread and that can be calculated by 0.5 into P, and P will be pitch here. T1 will be the thickness of nut head. T2 will be the thickness of base, that will be the formula of 2 into T1. T3 will be the thickness of body, that will be equal to 0.25 into D0. D0 will be the nominal diameter. H will be the height of nut and that can be calculated by formula N into P. L will be the length of the lever. H will be the height of head, that will be calculated by formula D into D. And height of the body will be the maximum lift plus height of nut plus 100 millimeter. So these are the few nomenclatures related to screw jacks. All these nomenclature, all the dimensioning part is being mentioned in this figure. Just go one by one, go by each section and each fetch out the value of H. I have just precised in a numerous way so that you can easily go through these the formulas. I have mentioned all the formulas one by one, how to calculate each values. So just go one by one, it will easily help you to solve numerical and solve, get to know you about the screw jack. Now I am going back to the next one, that is the design procedure. So I will teach you the design procedures, what are the procedures of designing a screw jack. So these are the design procedures of a screw jack. For that, first of all, we have to design the screw. So the first point here mentioned is the design of screw. So the design of a screw, for designing a screw, we have to calculate the first the direct compressive stresses. Just as I have written here, direct compressive stresses are induced in the screw due to application of load W, which I have given you in the previous figure. So direct compressive stress is developed due to the load W. So core diameter of the screw can be determined the formula of compressive stress by this formula, that is sigma c will be equals to W by pi by 4 into dc square. So through that, if we fetch out the value of sigma c, if we know the value of W, then the core diameter can be calculated. So through this, core diameter will be easily calculated. The diameter of the core diameter value can easily be calculated through this formula by knowing the value of W and sigma c. Now going to the next one, that is, in addition to compressive stress, screw is also subject to torsional shear stress. Obviously there will not be only compressive shear stress, there can be possibility of having torsional shear stress over there. For this, increase the value of core diameter, referring the standard table for screw travel and again diameter, the core determine the value of core diameter. So if there is a possibility of having torsional shear stress, then we have to go through the screw thread table in the data book and find the
वैल्यू ऑफ कोर डायमीटर रिलेटेड टू द वैल्यू ऑफ कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेस. सो थ्रू दैट वी कैन इजीली कैलकुलेटेड द और वी कैन ऑल्सो कैलकुलेटेड बाई दिस फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो दैट इज डी सी इक्वल्स टू डी जीरो माइनस पी दैट इज डी जीरो इज द नॉमिनल डायमीटर एंड पी विल बी द पिच. वी कैन कैलकुलेट बाय दिस फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो और वी कैन गो थ्रू द डेटा टेबल. वी कैन फैच द वैल्यू फ्रॉम दियर ऑल्सो एंड वी हैव टू कंपेयर दिस टू वैल्यूज दैट इज the dc we have calculated dc here also we have calculated dc or here also so it depending upon the values that you have to compare both these values and which will be the greater that we will consider. That means if we I am repeating once again if we will won't have any situation of torsional stress then we will simply calculated the dc from this formula and put it again in the problem or again in the design process in the further steps. But if we have possibilities of torsional stress also, then we have to compare the value of core diameter by these two formulas and which will be the greater number we will to fix that value and put in the further design procedures. So now getting to the next one, that is the torsional shear stress. For calculating the torsional shear stress, we have the formula of tau equals to 16 into T1 divided by pi into DC ka cube. Since we have calculated DC from here, we have the value of torsional shear stress. So we have to calculate the value of, for that, at first we have to calculate the value of T1. Then only we can calculate the value of torsional shear stress. So for calculating the T1, that what is T1 here? T1 is the torque required to rotate the screw. We have already gone through this formula as the how to calculate the torque, and that is W into 10 phi plus alpha into dm by 2, which I have already discussed to you in the previous section. That is the this is the situation of torque during raising of load. So this is the formula of that situation. We have put the simply this formula and calculate the value of T1. Now check whether principal stress is less than the permissible shear stress for safe dimension of screw or not. That means we have to check the tau max and sigma c max. That means the value of compressive stress and the torsional stress is under design procedure will be in safe situation or not. That means we have the value of sigma c and tau from here. We'll again calculate thus tau max and sigma c max by putting this sigma c and tau in these two formulas, and we'll check the values that whether it is in safe values conditions or not. How to check that whether it is safe or not? So we'll find a value that we'll easily get a value of tau max from by putting the value of sigma c and tau, and we can easily calculate the value of tau max. Again, we can easily calculate the value of sigma c max. We have some values in our data book. We have to compare these values with that. If it will be the less than that, then the design procedure is safe. If it will be the greater than that, then the design process will be not safe. I hope you understand. Nonetheless, I am repeating once again, starting from design of screw. First of all, calculate the value of DC from this formula. Then again, if we have a situation of torsional stress, then again compare the value of DC from here also. Then calculate the value of torsional stress by putting this formula. For T1, we have to go through this formula. Now, as we got the value of sigma c and tau both, now for calculating tau max, we have this formula. Just put the value of sigma c and tau, and for sigma c max, here also put the value of sigma c and tau, and find out the value of sigma c max and tau max. Now, upon calculating these two values, compare these values with the design data book. If these values will be less than that, then the design procedure is safe. If these two values will be greater than that, then the design procedure will not safe. I hope you understand now. Now getting back to the next section, that is the design of nut. So for designing the nut, the threads of nut and screw are engaged to each other. Obviously the thread will be engaged with each other, and there is relative motion between them under compressive load. Obviously if both are in contact and both will be moving, then there will must be a relative motion between that, and since it is a compressive load, hence nut may fail for the bearing pressure. That means obviously when we put extra compressive load, then upon the load the nut or the screw may break sometimes. It is general in our daily life we go through this type of situation. So there should be some bearing pressure. That means if we will put load above that pressure, then it will fail or it will break. And if we will under that limiting value, then there will be no destruction of that screw. So for that we have to calculate the bearing pressure. So that bearing pressure can be calculated by this formula. That will be the W by pi by 4 of D naught square minus DC square into N. So we have the value of W, we have the value of D naught and DC from the previous section. Now we have to calculate the value of N, where N is the number of threads engaged with the nut. What is N here? N is the number of threads engaged with the nut, is determined by the above equation. The height of the net can be calculated. That N can be, if we have the value of PB, then we can calculate the value of N from here. If we have the value of N, then we can calculate the PB from here. So indirectly, we will have in the problem the value of W, the value of D naught, the value of DC. Through this formula, we have to calculate the value of N or PB. So now, as we got the value of N, so it can easily calculate the height of the nut, and that can be calculated by the formula. That will be H equals to N into P. So we'll also get the value of H. Now, checking whether transverse shear stress in screw and nut are less than permissible shear stress for the safe dimension of nut. Again, we'll have to check the value that whether it is safe or not. For that, we have to calculate the value of tau screw throughout this formula. We have the value of N, we have the value of T, we have the value of DC, we have the value of W. We just calculate the value of tau screw. Again, we have to calculate the value of tau nut through this formula. We'll all have these all values. Just we have to simply put the values and calculate the value. Again, we will check this dimension, or we will compare this dimension with the actual values. If these values will be less than that, then the dimension will be safe or the design procedure will be safe. If it will be greater than that, the design process will not be safe. Now, the inner diameter, getting back to the next section, that is how to calculate the inner diameter. So D1 will be calculated. If we have calculated that the dinner fails under tensile strength, if sigma t will be W by pi by 4 into D1 square minus D naught square. So if we have the value of D1, we'll simply put the value, and we can easily calculate the D1 from this formula. From this formula, we can calculate the value of D2 by putting the crushing stress. Just simply concentrate that here we have the formula of tensile stress, and here we have put the formula of crushing stress. So for calculating the value of D1, we have to put the value of tensile stress. For D2, we have to put the formula of crushing stress. Thickness of nut color T1 fails under shear stress. So for that thickness, we have to put the value of shear stress. That will be, we have to put the value of tau, and from this formula it can be calculated. Now the next topic is the design of lever. How to design the, at first we have to design a screw, then design of nut, now design of lever. So for design of lever, the total torque transmitted by the handle will be calculated by T equals to T1 plus T2. Since T is the total torque, T can be calculated by load into distance. That will be the P into L. And T1 will be calculated by formula W into 10 pi plus alpha into dm by 2. I have already known through this. And T2 can be calculated either using uniform pressure theory or uniform wear theory. We have already gone through this in the previous sections. Now, handle may fail under bending stress. Diameter can determine by this formula. That will be M equals to P into L. Since we have the value of P, since we have the value of L, pi by 32 dh into sigma b. So we can calculate the value of dh from this formula. So this is the overall procedure of design of screw jack. That means at first we have to design the screw, design of screw, then we have to go through design of nut, and at final situation we have to go through the design of lever. So upon calculating this all procedure, we can easily completely design a screw jack by measuring all these dimensional factors. So I hope you understand that complete design procedure of screw jack. So go through this lecture and go through the sectional part of which I have discussed. Nonetheless, if you have any query, then let me know. Just solve few problems by using this procedure. You will easily all your doubts can be cleared out. Nonetheless, if you have any doubt, then let me know. Thank you for your attention in today's class.